Assalamu alaikum. Grace be to all of you and to our God, who's a God of love and a God of mercy. Lost lady. Ella, Christian, and Christopher, Christian, and all of the members of the family, Imam, we give thanks to you. Peace to God for all you've said. I come to you today in my faith tradition. I was down this week myself from the bed from facial cellulitis. And I asked God to allow me to be here today because of this brother. I want to encourage all of us to give. I want to say that there's a scholarship set up right for the baby. We left for the baby. Hold the baby. I know this is taking some of my time with the baby. They said the preachers didn't have 2 minutes, we had eight, so that's what they said. Isn't that what they told me? Nah. So that's on the sheet back there. So. But I got some friends out there. I don't normally talk about what I do, but I want to challenge you to get $500. I've done it. And there's some people out there, I'm looking at you. And not from your organization, from you personally. Then go get another $500 from your organization. And there are folk out here that can do it. There's some lawyers out here. There's some folk that can do it. And make sure you do it today. In my faith tradition, there's a scripture that's honored by all traditions. Psalm 13. 13 in the Kemet Society is the resurrection. Psalm 13 sounds pitiful. It says, "How long, Lord, will you forget me? How long will my enemies triumph over me? How long, Lord, will my tears put me to sleep? Or will I just sleep death?" And then it says in verse 6, "But I trust in your unfailing love, and my heart rejoices in your salvation. Therefore, I will barak God, I will praise God." When a life like Umar's is allowed to bless us, I want to suggest there are three things we have to do. We have to mourn. We must mourn. When a brother like Umar Muhammad comes our way, and when they're no longer with us in the flesh, you don't just walk away like don't even let anybody tell you, "Oh, just don't cry." No, if you're human and you love and you stood at the base of that mountain and knew you have to mourn. Sometimes when a person is absent, the whole world seems depopulated. The death of a beloved is an amputation, says C.S. Lewis. If the people we love are stolen from us, the way we have them live on is to never stop loving them, and part of never stop loving them is to take time to mourn them. I had an old lady said, "I don't care if you had an old raggedy car, if that car cranked in the morning and got you where you were supposed to go, and one day it just blew up," she said, "get out and just cry over it, just mourn and thank it for it. Just remember, don't just throw it in. Remember, mourn. Don't tell people not to mourn. God we serve cries. When the good die, we should mourn. When the warriors fall, we should mourn. When the lovers no longer have life, we should mourn. Blessed are they that mourn, that care deeply, that know that for a moment, for a few days, it feels like the whole world has been depopulated because that presence meant so much, but know that they shall be comforted. Then number two, not only must we mourn, we must have memory. Because we may have never imagined our brother's death this way. In fact, that was the title when I was writing this, "When Moments Happen That We Never Imagined." Can we own that for a minute? We may have never imagined. We imagine, can I be real? We imagine somebody shooting him, some racist or something, before this. Because we know the risk that come when you stand up for truth and when you challenge the system, right? But we're not doing that. But some never imagined his life would turn out the way it did either. Not only did we imagine, we couldn't imagine his death, but a lot of folks didn't imagine his life. From prison life to a purpose life. From captivity to calling. You gotta remember that, not just how he died, but how he lived. From being locked down to becoming the brothers who could lift up. This is what we must remember. His life was a life of renewal, a life of redemption, a life of revival, a life of restoration, and a life of resilience. That's why every time you remember it, you ought to rejoice. I'm not going to talk to you, but I remember. Every time then, you ought to dance like Mandela danced when he came out of jail. When you remember the life, and then let us remember, there have been many who, after captivity, became liberators. So let's remember the Hall of Fame that the name Umar now enters. Moses, after captivity, became a liberator. Joseph, after captivity, became a liberator. Jeremiah, after captivity, became a liberator. Jephthah, after captivity, became a deliverer. Jesus, after captivity, became a deliverer. Paul, after captivity, became a deliverer. Frederick Douglass, after captivity, became a deliverer. Malcolm, after captivity, became a deliverer. Martin, after captivity, in the Birmingham jail. Fannie Lou Hamer, after captivity, became a deliverer. Dennis Gaddy, after captivity, became a deliverer. Darrell Atkinson, after captivity, became a deliverer. And God is not through raising up liberators out of captivity. We must hold on to this way, not how long he lived. In my biblical tradition, there's a man that lived 968 years, and that's all it says. Just a pile of wasted cellulite. It's not how long you live. Not just and we can't just remember the necessary mourning. There is necessary mourning. But this brother was God breathed miracle. Give me 2 minutes and I'm through. Listen, it hit me back there. That's why I wasn't talking to y'all, because the Spirit was dealing with me. But I was sitting on yonder stool. And I said, God, show me, because I'm saying this brother was a God breathed miracle. The Lord said, you know, in most religious tradition, seven. Seven is the number of perfection. So he was born January 7th. 1987. He died July the 7th month, July, on the 17th day, in the 17th year of the 21st century, which is the multiplication of 7 times 3. He lived on this earth 11,149 days, divided by 7 is 1,592.7 days. I'm telling you, this brother was a God-breathed miracle. And the Quran tells us in the Surah 103, verse 1 through 3, by the declining day, lo, man is in a state of loss, except those who believe and do good works and exhort one another to truth and exhort one another to endurance. So we must remember. And finally, we must now, with the proper mourning and the proper memory, build a movement to honor his memory and all of those who went from captivity to liberty. Our brother said all of us are numbers. And if we love him, we must keep building the movement. All of us, none of us. The last time I was with him, he was fighting for Dante Sharp down in Greenwood. If you love Umar, let's turn it up for Dante Sharp. But that's where he was.
That's powerful. Get that brother out. Sisters, let's get Dante out. Brothers, let's get all of us. All of us must hold on to his family. All of us must make sure his daughter is raised and has everything. She's got to have many uncles now and many of us. All of us. All of us standing again against the new Jim Crow and the prison industrial complex and the racist attitudes of Jeff Sessions and the rest of the folk around him. All of us against racist voter suppression. All of us fighting to ensure everybody has health care. All of us fighting for living wages and development and infrastructure in poor communities. All of us standing against drugs dropped in our community and the soul of our community. All of us fighting for another better world for our children. All of us, let's keep building the movement he loved, the work he loved for all of us. All of us, rest our brother, but all of us are going to take up more of your work. You did more with a short time than most deal with a long time. We will not stop the work you love because we love you. All of us, all of us, all of us. Praise the God of our salvation. Assalamu alaikum. All of us will never stop calling and living the name of Umar Muhammad. All of us are